Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let me show you how to create a slideshow on your iPhone so you can export it as a video to share. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you can read more about it, join us, and get exclusive content. So if you've ever created a slideshow on your iPhone, you may have been frustrated by the fact that you can't really seem to share it anyway. What you've probably done is gone into the Photos app and then chosen photos, like for instance all the photos in this album. And then you can use the Share button at the bottom and choose Slideshow. And then you get this great slideshow, and you can even set up options like the music to use and speed and things like that. And you could play it, and you could even send it via AirPlay to an Apple TV or other device. But you can't export it as a video or share it in some way on social media. To do that, you're going to have to use another app. One that you can get for free is iMovie from Apple. If you don't already have it on your iPhone, you could just download it for free from the App Store. iMovie could be used for all sorts of things, editing your video and creating little video projects. But you can also use it to quickly create slideshows from your photos. So let's go into iMovie here and create a new project. I'm going to choose a movie type project. Then it's going to ask me to select some video or photos to get started. So since I want to create a slideshow here, I'm going to go into Photos. Actually, I'm going to go into Albums and then choose that same album. So here I am in that album, and I'm going to go and select all of the photos in it. And then I'm just going to tap Create Movie. Now actually, this is all I need to do if I don't want to customize it in any way. I can scroll back and forth with my finger and see all the photos are there in that order, and I can play and it will play through them. At this point I could be done and I could export, but I can also customize some things. Notice how each photo kind of moves. It goes from one point and one zoom level to another. This is called the Ken Burns effect. If you tap on the photo in the timeline there, you can see it gets a yellow outline. Now I can tap the clip button there at the left, and I can set the in and out zoom and position for the Ken Burns effect. So I could say move this over a little bit, go over here and say I want it to end there, maybe zoomed in. Or I can simply tap where it says Ken Burns enabled and turn it off. Now I'm still going to have to choose where to zoom in because photos are naturally 4:3 ratio, whereas video is 16:9. In other words, video is very rectangular and photos are a lot closer to square. So you need to be able to crop a little bit off the top and bottom for it to fit. That's one of the reasons the Ken Burns effect is the default, is because you could show more of your photo that way. You could make other changes as well. For instance, I can tap on the transition marker in between each photo, and I could set it to a different type of transition like sliding or wiping or fading or even none. I can set the amount of time for a photo, so I can shrink it or enlarge it so that photo is on the screen longer. I can tap here to set a filter for that photo, so change how it looks. And I could tap the T button there and add some text using one of these text templates here. And then I could just tap the text, type some text, and put a caption on it. That might be useful to do, say, on your first photo and your last photo if you're not going to do it for any of the others even. If you tap off of any of the photos in the timeline, you'll have a little settings button at the bottom right. And you could tell it to use the music from the theme. And you can notice that there are themes there at the bottom. Simple theme is probably what you want most of the time, but you can use some of those other themes as well. You can also set whether it fades in at the beginning or fades out at the end. And you could set a filter at the top for the entire slideshow. Now you could also, at any time you want, hit the plus button to add more things. So you could add another photo, you can add another video, you could add some audio, so just a piece of music or some sound effects that you could put there in the timeline. You can actually record directly from your camera or use VoiceOver to record your voice and create narration for the slideshow. Now when you're done, just hit the Done button at the top left, and now you're back to the Projects view, and I only have this one project here. I can tap the name of it to name it, and I can tap the Edit button to go back in. I can use the Play button at the bottom to simply play it now, but I can use the Share button at the bottom. And now I can export it. You can see I can export directly to things like Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube and such if I have those apps installed. Otherwise, I can hit Save Video and it will save it out as a video file to my Photos app. So you can see I've got several different options there for sizes. I could choose, say, 720, and it will export the movie as a 720p video. Then I have it in my Photos app and I could share it. So that's how easy it is to create a slideshow in iMovie. Now there are a ton of other apps that will also create slideshows, but iMovie is free, it's from Apple, and it's pretty versatile. There's a lot of different things that you can do with it. First time you do it, it's probably going to take you a little time to get used to, but after you make one, it becomes very quick to be able to make other slideshows. The best thing is you can do it right on your iPhone while you're traveling, while you're at an event. Take some photos, make a slideshow, and share it right from your phone. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.